And as long as we're here as a father, as a mother, a grandfather, uncle, and whoever you are, we gotta be salt and we have to be light so that our children and grandchildren will follow Christ. Because if we can't really be that light and that witness, then who's gonna really believe you when you share the gospel with them? We have to be so careful.
Welcome to Somebody Loves You Radio, the Bible teaching ministry of Roel Reese in Diamond Bar, California. We're glad to have you along for our continued study of Revelation and its insights into the world's last days. As Roel explores the complex imagery of Satan's final attack on Israel, you'll see evidence of God's untouchable power. Roel will show us that even in the global chaos that lies ahead, the Lord will remain sovereign and His end-time plans will be fulfilled under His steady control. Let's join Roel Reese now in the book of Revelation, chapter 12.
This is a pretty interesting chapter. And I know that John, the beloved, as he's writing this chapter, he's really concerned about the signs that are given here. Because in these three signs that are given to us tonight are going to be signs that we're going to understand. This is now in the middle of the tribulation period. The first 3.5 years have come, have passed, and now the last 3.5 years. Where Israel at this particular moment is going to make their exodus. They're going to exit across from Jerusalem, across to the Jordan River, across the Jordan River over to the Arab side, and they're going to go over to the city of Petra, the city of rock. If they would have never left Jerusalem and gone to Petra, they would have been wiped out. One third of Israel are going to be taken care of in the city of Petra. Israel is going to be still here today because it's a 7-year tribulation. First 3.5 years, the Antichrist is introduced. In the last 3.5 years, the Antichrist takes possession of the world. And if you don't bow to him, he's going to kill you. The church will not be here. The church is gone. In the book of Matthew, he tells us about the tribulation period. Let me read you something that's really amazing to me. In Matthew chapter 24, where he speaks about the future, he says this, beginning with verse 15. He says, therefore, when you see the abomination desolation spoken by Daniel, the prophet, standing in the holy place, the holiest of holies. He says, then in those days, he says, let those who are in Judea flee to the mountains. Speaking of the Jews, going to the mountains. Let him who is on the housetop not come down and take anything out of his house. And let him who is in the field not go back and get his clothes. But woe to those who are pregnant in those days, who are nursing babies in these days. And pray that your flight may not be in the winter on the Sabbath. For then there will be great tribulation. You remember the first 3.5 years is not great tribulation, it's tribulation. But the last 3.5 years is the great tribulation. The worst that has ever happened. So he goes on. He says, unless those days were shortened, no flesh will be able to be saved. But for the elect's sake, the Jews, those days will be shortened. Then if anyone says to you, look, here is the Messiah, and there, do not believe it. For false Christ and false prophets will rise up and show great signs and wonders to deceive, if possible, even the very elect. Who's the very elect? The Jews. See that I have told you beforehand. Don't ever tell me I didn't tell you. Therefore, because of this, if they say to you, look, he is in the desert, don't go out there. Or look, he is in the inner rooms. Don't believe it. For as the lightning comes from the east, flashes from the west, so also will the coming of the Son of Man be. For wherever the carcass is, there the eagles will be gathered together. And immediately after the tribulation of those days, the sun will become darkened. So the first 2.5 years, now we're going into the 2.5. Notice what he says. The next 3.5. He says, after the tribulation of those days, the sun will be darkened. The moon will not give its light. The stars will fall from the heaven. The powers will be shaken. And then the Son of Man will be appearing in heaven, the second coming. And man will appear in heaven, Jesus. And then all the tribes of the earth will mourn. They will see the Son of Man coming in clouds of heaven with power and great glory. Yeah, great glory is coming too, but great glory says here. And he will send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet. And they will be gathered together to his elect from the four winds and from one end of heaven to the other. And then he goes into the next verse and he gives you a parable of Israel as a fig tree. Now learn, he says, this parable from the fig tree. When its branches are already become tender and put forth leaves, you know that summer is near. So May 14, 1948, Israel, after 2,000 years, they went back to what? To their land. They built a nation, which before 2,000 years, nothing about the Jews. Now they've been there 70-some years in Israel. He goes on. He says, you know that summer is near. So they're back there. We know summer is near. The Lord is coming. So you also, you see all these things, know that it's near. He says, at the doors. As surely I say to you, this generation will by no means pass away until all these things take place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will by no means pass away. And then he says, but of the day and the hour, no one knows, not even the angels of heaven, but my Father only. But as in the days of Noah were, so also will the coming of the Son of Man be. For as the days before the flood, they were eating, drinking, marrying, and giving in marriage until the day that Noah entered into the ark. So Noah entered into the ark. The church is going to be raptured. We're not going to be here. He goes on. And this is pretty amazing to me. Because as in the days of Noah, he says, verse 39, it did not know until the flood came and took them all away, so also will be the coming of the Son of Man be. He says, then two men will be in the field, one shall be taken, the other left. Two women will be grinding at the mill, one shall be taken, the other left. And then he says, watch or be on the alert, therefore, for you do not know what hour your Lord is coming. Here we are. We don't know what time he's coming. People at the rapture of the church, we don't know what that's going to happen. The second coming, yes, 7 years, tribulation period, and then Christ comes at the second coming after the last 7 years. He goes on. But know this, that if the master of that house have known what hour the thief was coming, he would have watched, notice, and not allow his house to be broken into. Therefore, you also be ready, for the Son of Man is coming in an hour you don't expect him. So here we are. He may come tonight. He may come tomorrow. He may come a month from now. He may come 1,000 years from now. He keeps his promises. The rapture is the key to finishing the last 70 years of world history. To complete 490 years. 1 week left. And the church is holding back that week. Because the moment the church is raptured and we're no longer here, man, boom, the Antichrist comes up. And they talk about this world leader. Boom, he chooses 10 leaders, 10 nations. He has a false prophet that will be with him. And as long as we're here as a father, as a mother, a grandfather, uncle, and whoever you are, we gotta be salt and we have to be light so that our children and grandchildren will follow Christ. If not, we're wasting our time. Because if we can't really be that light and that witness, then who's going to really believe you? We have to be so careful. Let's look at it in chapter 12 now, beginning with verse 1. He says, "And now a great sign appeared in heaven, a woman." Right away, the woman is who? Israel. Mark that down. It's Israel, the nation of Israel. He says, "A woman clothed with the sun," speaks of glory, "the moon at her feet," submission, "and her head as garlands and 12 stars." So here you have the woman Israel, the 12 tribes of Israel. Wow. And then he says in verse 2, "and being with a child." I mean, here this woman is going to have a child. And here as we see this being the child, she cried out in labor and in pain to give birth. So the nation of Israel in her anguish, seeking to be relief. What happened? The nation of Israel, a Messiah is born. But a woman was chosen by the Lord to have this child. And this child was who? Jesus.
This is Somebody Loves You Radio with Raul Reese. For Bible-rich resources to strengthen your faith and guide you in God's perfect will, browse our online store at somebodylovesyou.com. Raul's comprehensive study of Revelation is conveniently available on both CD and USB drive. Let's continue now with more from our study in Revelation.
He goes on, verse 3. "And another sign appeared in heaven. Behold, a great fiery red dragon." Who's that? No interpretation. You know who he is? Satan, the devil, the adversary. "Having 7 heads and 10 horns." So he's going to tell you here, the devil is not only going to rise up, but there's going to be 10 nations, the coming community market in the last days. There will be 10 nations, 10 leaders, the Antichrist, a false prophet, and 10 leaders, which already is in working of it. We're beginning to see it. He goes on. "And 7 diadems on his head." So the red speaks of what? The blood that was shed by who? By Jesus. The blood that was shed by Jesus. Defeated the dragon. Who? Satan. And then the 10 horns speaks of the future kingdoms. Daniel chapter 7, verse 7, and verse 20, and verse 24. When you go back to Daniel chapter 7, you can read that. Satan has not only known that he's going to be defeated, but Satan has not only lied, but he's also brought Israel into pain. Into pain. He hates Israel. He hates the church. His tail, now he's giving the description, his tail drew a third of the stars. So now he's going to take a little bit, going back in time. He says, when the devil was in heaven, he was a beautiful creature. I mean, you have Gabriel, you have Michael, and then you had Satan. Beautiful, beautiful angels. Satan got a little bit proud, as we have in Isaiah 14, Ezekiel 28, and he got kicked out of heaven. But as he gets kicked out of heaven, he draws one third of the angels with him. They followed him, and they become demons. He says he still drew a third of the stars speaking of angels, of heaven, and drew them to the earth. And the dragon stood before the woman who was ready to give birth to devour her child as soon as it was born. Matthew's gospel, Mary having a child, and the dragon, remember Herod? Herod said, "I want you to go out and find who he is." After the 3 magi came, remember, they said, "Hey, what did you see?" Then he never came back. He hears about this child born, so he thinks, "You guys go out and kill every child under age of 2 years old, kill them," thinking he would kill the Messiah, but he didn't, according to Scripture. He sailed through a third of the stars of heaven, drew them to the earth, and the dragon stood before the woman who was ready to give birth to defile her child, Jesus, as soon as he was born. But what happened? The Lord protected his son. Notice in verse 5. And so she bore a male child and was to rule all the nations with a rod of iron. Speaking of who? Jesus. And their child, capital C, was caught up to God in his throne. So he tells you now, Jesus came, died, and went back to heaven, which we read that in the Gospels. So he's telling you here. She bore a male child who was ruled all the nations with a rod of iron, and her child was caught up to God in his throne. And then the woman fled into the wilderness. So now here we are, first 3.5 years, now the last 3.5 years, the great tribulation. Israel, Antichrist is coming after them. One third of them get up, they flee to the wilderness, across the Jordan, over to the city of Petra. Verse 7, and war broke out in heaven. Michael and his angels fought. When you think of Gabriel, there's Michael, then Gabriel. Gabriel, the archangel, he's the one that interprets Daniel's visions. Remember Daniel chapter 8, 16 to 17. And then he reveals the prophecy of the 70 week in Daniel chapter 9, 21 to 27. And then he announces John the Baptist's birth in Luke 1, 11 to 22. And then he announces Christ's birth in Luke 1, 26 to 38. So Gabriel, Michael, they're very well used by the Lord. These are archangels that are used by the Lord. Satan, beautiful, beautiful angel, kicked out of heaven. Beautiful, beautiful angels kicked out of heaven, one third, and they became all demons. He goes on, verse 8. But they did not prevail. There was a place found for them in heaven any longer. So here the devil, his demons are going to be what? They're going to lose the battle. They know that. So what is he doing right now? He knows that he's losing the battle. He's going to be cast into the lake of fire. So what is he trying to do? I'm going to take as many people as I can with me to hell and to the lake of fire. He's running a race against time right now. So don't be discouraged when you're tempted by Satan. He wants to discourage you, but he wants to defeat you. Fully, completely defeat your life. Greater is he that is in me than he that is of the world. You have the power. I rebuke thee, Satan. He goes on. In verse 9, he says, so the great dragon was cast out, the serpent of old called the devil, Satan, who deceives the whole world. He was cast up to the earth. The angels were cast up with him. Then I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ have come. For the accuser of our brethren, who's accusing you? Who's accusing me? The devil. Listen, for the accuser of our brethren who accused them before our God day and night. Wait a minute, day and night? Day and night, he never stops, has been cast down. Boom, he's done. Done. And they overcame Satan by the blood of the Lamb, Jesus, his death, and by the word of their testimony, our testimony in Christ Jesus, living a holy life. And they did not love their lives unto death. Hey, you can kill me, but I will not deny him. You don't want me to preach sin? You can kill me, but I will not deny him. I will preach on sin. No government's ever going to stop me. I'm going to preach the truth. I'm going to speak the truth, even if I'm incarcerated or killed, I don't really care. And I think for all of us, we need to prepare for that. That the Lord has saved you, the Lord has come to your life. He's using you, he will continue to use you, and he will say one day, are you willing to give your life? Think of all the missionaries that have given their lives in communist countries. Governments have tried to put a stop to them, and they say, you can take my life, and you don't take my life. You can't take Jesus away from us. I'll die for him. He died for me. like in the tribulation period, those that are left behind after the rapture of the church, all of a sudden the Antichrist, your brother, your sister, your wife, they go, man, you know what she told me was true. They're gone. And now on TV, they're saying there's a leader now that is going to take over the world. And this is what he wants from every person. And he says what? That they're going to be there, that once you take the mark of the beast, you are done. You are done. So what does he do? You don't want to do it? Give me your head. They take your head off and you'll go to heaven. But you were left behind. Man, you don't want to be left behind. Times are going to be horrible. Horrible. Like the world has never, ever seen. He goes on, verse 12. And because of this, rejoice, O heavens, and you who dwell in them, woe to the inhabitants of the earth, notice, and the sea. For the devil has come down to you, having great wrath, because he knows that he has a short time. Now, when the dragon saw that he had been cast to the earth, he persecuted the woman. Who's the woman? Israel. He gave birth to who? The child, male, Jesus. But the woman was given two wings as a great eagle. Here it is again. As an eagle, that she might fly to the wilderness, to her place, the city of Petra, where she is nourished for a time, 3.5 years. Notice, from the presence of the serpent, she is going to be protected by the Lord. Satan cannot touch her at all. God is going to protect her. He goes on. So then the serpent, the devil, spewed water out of his mouth like a flood after the woman, after Israel, that he might cause her to be carried away by the flood. Notice, God protects Israel. No one can touch her. The devil wants to destroy her, but they can. Notice, he can't destroy Israel. Verse 16, but the earth helped the woman, and the earth opened its mouth and swallowed up the flood, which the dragon has spewed out of his mouth. The great, great army, they will come against Israel like a flood. This army, they will come, speaking of what? The battle of Armageddon coming up. And the dragon was enraged with the woman. She hates Israel, man. He hates Israel. And the dragon was enraged with the woman, and he went to make war with the rest of her offspring, who kept the commandments of God and had the testimony of Jesus Christ. 144,000 will come and preach the gospel. And then Jew and Gentile during this period that are saved, because there are going to be people saved in the last 7 years. Because those that are taken out of the way, those that are beheaded, people still will be getting saved. And at the end of the second coming, what happens? God is going to make a distinction. Those that go into the kingdom age in the tribulation period, notice, those that have Christ go into the tribulation period, into the kingdom age, Gentile and Jew. But those who receive the mark of the beast, they're gone. The lake of fire. Hell, lake of fire. Satan, lake of fire. Antichrist, lake of fire. False prophet, lake of fire. And then the robe here. And it says what? He opened the books, and whoever's name was not found written in the book of life was cast with Satan, the Antichrist, the false prophet, every demon into the lake of fire forever and ever and ever and ever. No turning back.
The imagery of a dragon attacking a woman can appear a bit fantastical, but with a closer look, this surprising vision provides helpful clarity into the Lord's absolute sovereignty. You're listening to Somebody Loves You Radio with Raul Reese. Now, if you'd like to hear today's message in its complete form, we'll send a copy to you for a donation of $5 or more. Just call us at 800-634-9165 and mention today's study from Revelation chapter 12. Now, to further enrich your understanding of the world's future, we'd like to tell you about Raul's entire 28-lesson Revelation series. Available on either CD or thumb drive, this resource unpacks the Bible's end times prophecy and illuminates the relentless love underscoring God's end time plans. To order Rawls' 28-part Revelation study, visit somebodylovesyou.com or call 800-634-9165. We'll send you the CD collection for a gift of $36 or the USB drive for $30. The number once again is 800-634-9165. You can also order by writing us at Somebody Loves You Radio, Post Office Box 4440, Diamond Bar, California, 91765. Your partnership helps us keep sharing the Bible through these broadcasts, and we are grateful for your tax-deductible gifts. Next time on Somebody Loves You Radio, we'll continue our study of Revelation with powerful confirmation that Jesus will win the final battle on this earth, while Satan's limited time reign will end in fiery judgment. This program is sponsored by Somebody Loves You Radio in Diamond Bar, California.